Hi, I'm Aprille Walker from the Yoga Ranger Studio, and today's practice, we're going to focus on a really deep look at the entire hip complex, and that includes the outside of the hip, the front side of the hip, the back side. Obviously getting a little bit of the quadricep, a little bit of the hamstring, and so covering this entire space. So what you might need for this practice is a blanket underneath, or a towel, a folded up blanket or towel, and potentially a block for some of the poses that we have. If you were like me and have a little bit shorter arms and the ground needs to come up to you just a little bit, we're gonna take those off to the side. And our first pose we're gonna start with is child's pose. So we're gonna take a nice wide kneed stance here. Big toes together. Lucy's an extra prop. If you need her, you can have her. And then go ahead and keep your hips low and walk your hands out in front of you. We're not too much worried today about the arms and shoulders. So you can rest your head on your hands or on the blanket or a block. And just start to bring your awareness to your breath. Connecting with your inhale and exhale and allowing it to start to get a little bit deeper and longer. Maybe lengthening it to 5 or 6 counts on the inhale. Maybe a little longer on your exhale. Now, if your knees do not like this position, you can always take that towel or blanket and just tuck the edges of it underneath between your hamstrings and your calves, in between the knee. And that'll give you a little bit of space behind the knee and make it more comfortable. Maybe after this first minute, you start to find that you can lower yourself down a little bit more. Maybe resting your head on the floor. Now, as always, you want to feel some sense of stretching or sensation. And for each person, where that is will be very different. But if you feel any sharp shooting pains or pains that make it so you can't breathe or you catch your breath, you want to come out of this pose, bring your knees closer together. Maybe take the lying down on the back version of this, which is just to lay down on your back, bring your knees into your chest and grab hold of your ankles. And that'll release some of the pressure in the knees and hips. Start to settle into the space, your mat, your body, becoming aware of each breath, each sensation. Last minute here. Gently lift your head, start to walk your hands back in. You're gonna press into your palms and lift up so you can bring those knees together. And you can either just sit here or you can go ahead and just walk your hands down, taking some of the compression out of the inside and outside of the hips. Just a couple more breaths here. It's always good to take a little break in between each one of these postures to allow the body to come back to neutral. And also for you to catch your breath, notice the sensations from neutral to the pose and back again. Then come back up. So this next pose we're going to take is frog pose. So you have a couple of choices here with that block. You can use it as a little prop underneath your chest. You're going to take your knees wide, turn your feet out, and line up your ankles with your knees, toes flexed. So you may be able to come down farther, you may be able to not come as far. That's really, every person is different. You can come down onto your elbows. Try to keep your hips in line with your knees. Sometimes that's hard because it's hard to know exactly where they're at. If they're a little bit behind, that's not really a big deal. If they're in front, you know, if they're way far back, that might be a little uncomfortable. We're gonna hold this for a little while. So if the block gives you a little bit of help, you can use it underneath your belly or hips to give you a little bit of prop so that there's not so much compression. And if your knees hurt here, you can always fold the blanket in and double it up. So I find that just having that little bit of lift from the block makes this a bit more comfortable. Take this first minute to settle into your posture. Everybody's hips and pelvis are made very different, and so each person's version of this pose will look quite different. If you feel sensation in the inside and the outside of the hip, the outside and the inside of the leg, then you are getting everything you need. And if you don't feel a huge amount, don't worry, because we stay in these poses for so long, sometimes that builds toward the end. So in yin, we kind of find a place and we hang out here, but sometimes you'll approach a certain point where you feel like you can just sink down a little bit deeper and feel free to go there. And sometimes you'll say, no, I think I want to stay right where I'm at, and feel free to stay there. It's just where you're at today, and that may be completely different tomorrow or the next day. Just about four more deep breaths here. Usually about at this point, you've sort of settled into the pose and it doesn't feel as new. So remember, in yin, we always practice, we take ourselves to about two-thirds of our maximum, so you wouldn't want to come down as far as you normally would in a yang practice, because you don't hold it as long, but a little bit shy of that because you're gonna be hanging on to it. So it has to be a sustainable posture. Last deep breath. Now the way to come out of this is to take your feet, flip the toes, walk them back in a little bit so they're pointing toward each other. Walk your elbows back in. press back just a little bit and start to drag one knee and then the other very slowly back to the center. Here you can take any number of postures. You can take cat-cow for 5 breaths, so you can take downward facing dog. Always taking that little break in between. Frog is often a very intense pose for the inside of the legs. Now we're going to take cow pose. So I find that having a blanket for cow pose really helps me. So we're going to take left over right. Thankfully, Lucy gave me my blanket back. Cross it over. If cow face pose is not your friend because of your knees, you can take this right leg out straight and cross the left leg over as far as comfortable for you. So some people can come all the way down to the floor, their hips touch the floor, their bum touches the floor, and their feet are out to the side. I'm not made that way, and you might not be either. And that's okay, you can prop yourself up either with the block or the blanket. Take a couple of breaths here to sit up tall. Maybe you start to move this left foot out a little bit more to the right side. And then go ahead and start to fold yourself forward. So if you're really good right here and you feel a lot of sensations, stay upright. If you're not sitting on your block, you can take the block, put it out in front of you and give yourself a little bit of lift to the floor so it's not as much. Or you can take your fingertips down to the floor into cupcakes or palms flat. If you're feeling very open today and you're comfortable and it's sustainable for you, you can fold as far as you feel you can hold for 3 minutes. So breathe into the hips. Breathe into the knees. I like to keep a little bit of flexion in my right and left feet so that my knee is protected. If you haven't been with me before online, this is Lucy. She's in some videos. She's very insistent about being involved. There's little I can do to stop her from coming in the room, even if I tried. Sometimes in this pose or in other poses, you will find you reach a point where you really want out of the pose. Know that after a few more breaths, you will be coming out of this pose. So have a little patience, breathe into that space. Just about 2 more deep breaths here. Now I like to rock a little bit forward to come out of this pose so I can shift back into downward facing dog or cat-cow again. If you're in downward facing dog, walk your dog out a few steps. Bend the knees. Find a little motion in the hips. and then gently come back down. We're gonna shift sides. So this time you're gonna take right over left. Every side is different. Our bodies are not symmetrical, so if your body doesn't act the same way, that's okay. Once again, you can take this left leg out straight, cross the right over it for a half pigeon, or not half pigeon, half cow face pose. It's Tuesday, I can always tell. Sit up tall for a few breaths. Let your hips sink into either the floor, the mat, a blanket, or a block. And then when and if you feel ready, go ahead and walk your hands down, fold into whatever version. Once again, you can use that block underneath your fingertips, bring the floor to you, keeping your toes a little bit flexed to protect your knees. Maybe on this side, you come down a little bit further, or maybe you're a little higher up. Just about two more deep breaths here. And then gently, once again, rock forward. Come on to hands and knees for cat-cow. Or you can take your downward facing dog again. Just walking your dog out. Finding a little movement here. Coming back down onto your hands and knees, we're going to take dragon poses. So here's where your blanket and your block might come in handy. If you have sort of tender knees, you can take the blanket across. Take both knees on top of it. Take your right leg out first, and you're gonna walk it forward. And I like to take my fingertips down, lift that back knee off, pull it toward me just a little bit, and rest my foot flat, okay? So here's where our block is going to come in. We're going to take our hands on either side of that front foot for our low pigeon here. If this is more comfortable, you can always take your hands to the inside of the foot and you can take that block underneath your palms. If you don't need it, you don't have to have it. Keep that knee pointing up toward the ceiling, foot completely flat, and that knee pressing into your shoulder, shoulder pressing into your knee. Wherever you are, you're going to walk your right foot over to the right just a little bit. Roll onto the outside edge of your right foot. Walk your hands in a little bit closer down the middle and lower down to wherever you want to. So for some people, coming down to your forearms is comfortable. And if that is for you, we're going to be here for 2 minutes. So once again, choose a sustainable position. Breathe into the inside and outside of that right hip. And continue to connect with your breath, your awareness. One more deep inhale and exhale. And then begin to walk your left hand a little bit closer down the middle. You're going to twist to your right. Take your right hand and grab onto your knee. So instead of pressing the knee away, you're going to grab onto it and secure it and twist from the center, so your core. Just three more deep breaths. Start to come back to center. Begin to bring that foot back to the middle and rock back to half splits. So you don't have to straighten this leg out completely. We're just going to be here for about 5 breaths. And rock forward, take that knee back. You can either come back into child's pose or just sit back into hero pose. Couple of breaths. Noticing the difference on the right side now that we've done that entire right side. Maybe feel the space we've opened up on the right side. And on to our left. Go ahead and come up on your knees. Step that left leg forward. So remember that you could use the block here again. Walk that foot back. Hands down, you're gonna lift that back knee off. Drag it forward a little bit. I like to take my ankle out a little further at a slight angle or right on underneath the knee. You can take your fingertips on either side or inside or on a block. So you may find that maybe this side is a little bit tighter. A little less compliant. Press the knee into the elbow, elbow into the knee or shoulder. And just let gravity help those hips open. So the goal of yin is to mobilize and strengthen the cold tissues of the body. Those cold tissues include ligaments, joints, connective tissue, as well as bone. Connective tissue intertwines, encircles, and encompasses, and is part of every single organ, muscle, bone attachment, joint, ligament. It is everywhere in your body. But there is more of it between the center of your quadricep up to your belly button. This is a very dense connective tissue area, which is why a lot of the poses in yin focus very heavily on this area. Once again here, you're going to turn that left foot out just a little bit to the left. Roll into the outside of the left foot. Here you may find that if you were on the block, you may not need it anymore, or you could continue to use it. Walk your hands so they're straight down underneath your shoulders. 2 minutes here. last deep inhale and exhale. Start to walk that right hand more down the center. Take that left hand, grab hold of the knee and secure it in space, and twist from your core to the left. Begin to unwind. Take those hands down, walk your foot back to the center, and go ahead and start to rock back for your half splits. Just five breaths. You can rock a little bit forward, bring that foot back, either come into child's pose or sit back in hero pose or thunderbolt pose with your feet underneath you, just for a couple of breaths. Now our next pose is going to be fire log pose. I always use a blanket for this pose underneath my seat. We're going to take that right foot out in front, flex the toes, and line it up with the edge of the mat or the edge of your blanket. You're going to tuck your right, left foot underneath the right knee. Sit up nice and tall to start with. If you can have your knees all the way down to the floor and take this ankle up on top, you can go ahead and take the full fire log. But I like to just rest my elbows on my knees and just gently put a little pressure to fold those down. So you might find you have to kind of keep adjusting a little bit in those first few breaths. If you have more open hips, you may find that you can rest and rock all the way forward. Once again, you can use your block underneath your forehead here if you're there. You might find after a few breaths you can take your fingertips down, still weighing those elbows down onto those knees. Keeping a little bit of flexion in the foot to protect the knee joint. Settle into your pose. Start to walk your hands back in unwind yourself. Take those feet wide and just windshield wiper for three breaths here. Most people find that pose is extremely intense for the outer hips. So we hold a little less time. Go ahead and take that right underneath, left in front this time. Flex the toes a little bit. Sit up on the very edge of your blanket. Walk those heels underneath the knees. Sit up for a breath and then rest those elbows on there and start to fold forward. Once again, kind of finding your place here. Very gently begin to walk those hands back up. Take those feet wide and flat. Rock them side to side. A couple of breaths here before we move on to our backs. So for our next pose, we're going to take this blanket and we're going to roll it up a little bit differently. Roll it the short way. So we have like a little roll there. Take it off to the side, lay all the way down, press the feet into the floor, and you're going to shift your hips and lift them up so that you can take that blanket right underneath the sacrum. So right top of the pelvis, base of the spine. Take a couple of breaths here. We're going to bring that right knee into the chest, give it a little squeeze, and then go ahead and reach inside. Grab hold of the outside edge or inside edge of that right foot and come into half happy baby. So you can keep this left leg, left knee bent, let it drop out to the side just a little bit. So with a little bit of effort here, you're going to pull that knee in a little bit further. This is going to be assisted with the tilt from the blanket. We're just going to be here about a minute and a half. Left. Slowly release that foot. Bring both knees back up to center, and you're going to walk that right leg out so that the heel is down. If your block is not in the way, toes are up. Just feel a stretch across the front of the right hip, right thigh. And then gently switching sides. So bring that right foot flat to the floor. Bring that left knee in, give it a hug. Reach inside the leg. If you can't grab hold of the foot, you can always just grab the ankle or grab the inside or outside of the foot. Some people find that one grip is a little easier than the other. Take that right knee out to the side a little bit. Kind of pull that knee down a little bit so you get more stretch. So there's a yang factor here to this pose. You're using your arm and shoulder to really pull that foot down, and you're sort of flexing the foot strongly to get that leverage. Just about 30 more seconds here. Go ahead and release that foot. Bring both knees up toward the ceiling and then just start to slide that left heel out, toes up. Take a few breaths into the right and left front of the thigh. And then go ahead and take both feet out straight. Take your arms out to the side, tuck the shoulder blades underneath for a little supported bridge. I like this pose after Happy Baby because it can really sense the energy running up and down the front of the hip flexors and the pelvis, the outside of the hip. Sort of a lightness, a tingling. Then go ahead and bring those feet flat to the floor. Press your feet, lift your hips, take that blanket off to the side. And you're going to cross that right ankle over that left knee, flex the toes. I like to grab hold of that ankle with my left hand and start to walk it over to the left and then drop it down so the foot is flat. So you want to have your foot completely flat on this side. You're going to kind of press that knee away from you for your twist. Right hand goes out to the right. You can turn and look over your right shoulder if you like or not. If you want a little bit more side body stretch, you can take your arm out at an angle. This is going to give you more stretch down the side, right side body, right hip and arm. on an inhale, turn back to center. Bring those knees back through center, unwind. Rock them side to side a little bit. And then switch. Take that left ankle across. Grab hold of it with your right hand. Pull it down so that it falls flat on the floor. Turn and look over your left shoulder. You can take that arm out at an angle to get more stretch in the front side of the chest and side body of the left. Inhale, turn your head back to center. Bring those knees back through center. Unwind, drop your feet a little wider. Rock your knees side to side. Now here you can drop your knees together and take your feet wide for your shavasana. Or you could take your heels out to the corners of the mat. Arms out to the side, palms facing up. Take this time to allow your body to absorb all it has learned in this practice. Settle your mind and body and allow yourself this little bit of time to rest. Gently start to deepen your breath, filling your belly, your chest, your collarbones. Maybe gently rocking your head side to side, wiggling your fingers and your toes. Beginning to walk your feet back to center. On an inhale, bring those knees into your chest, give them a little squeeze. And then exhale, roll over to your right side. Take a couple of breaths here on your right side. And then when you're ready, press yourself up into whatever seated position you like best. You can keep your eyes closed or open. Take your hands palms up or palms down onto your knees. On your next exhale, drop your fingertips down to the floor. Inhale, sweep the hands all the way up overhead. Open your eyes, look up at your palms. Exhale, hands to heart. Peace and namaste. I hope you enjoyed this deep hip practice. If you did, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe down below. There is a button. This gets you informed of what new videos come up, and I do upload a new video every single week. Practice, usually yin. I hope to see you again on the mat. Thank you so much for joining me today. Namaste.